Create a new project. All right, today we will start with market basket analysis. Market basket analysis, also known as affinity analysis, or in data mining they used to call it as association rule mining. So market basket analysis, also known as affinity analysis, also called as association rule mining in data mining. So it has great implications in retail. When I say in retail, I'm talking about retail sales, either in a supermarket or an e-commerce site or any place. What are the combination of products people are buying? Catalog management, product management, all these things are related to market basket analysis. Okay, this is a basically finding patterns, finding buying patterns, finding buying patterns by extracting association rules, by extracting association rules. This is the most important thing you need to understand with this thing. The algorithm that they use is a priori algorithm. So a priori algorithm generates the association rules. A priori algorithm generates these association rules. So a typical rule will be like this. If product A is bought then product B will also be bought based on certain probability generated from transaction rules. So basically, combination of products. Which are those combination of products? What is the probability of their buying? Is what this a priori algorithm will give you. So a priori algorithm is a very powerful algorithm which uses, which generates rules. And these rules are used by the algorithm to calculate probability. Okay, so it will create probabilities. Okay, so based on their probabilities, it will give you the combination of products which will be bought together accordingly. The supermarkets can organize those products in same racks or adjacent racks, or an e-commerce website can suggest those products as suggested products on along with those products. So such things can be done using this market basket analysis. Okay, all of you are clear with the basics of market basket analysis?
Yes sir.
Yeah,
yes sir.
So let us understand certain keywords. There are certain keywords you need to understand. Keywords in market MBA or market basket analysis. First keyword is items. Now items are products that are identified based on frequency or based on associations. Based on associations, we have created these items. Basically, items is your whole set of products. So, whole set of products which are there in your data. That is your, basically, your items. Okay. A group of items, we call it as item set. Item set means a group of items. We call it as item set. So, these are the goods or item set includes all the products that are grouped together based on transactions. Okay. Now,
yes, sir, also, now.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt? Support. Support of a product is based nothing but the fraction or ratio of product to transactions in data. Support. So support is fraction or ratio of products in the data. That is one thing you need to understand. Support is a keyword which you see in market basket analysis. This support will tell you how many times the product is appearing in the total item set. How many times the product is appearing in the total item set. Take for example, basically it's a frequency. Okay. Now if you are looking at support formula, support of, let us say, rule X is equal to transactions containing both X and Y. Transactions containing both X and Y. And the denominator is total number of transactions. Total number of transactions. So this is the formula for support. Support of X to Y. Support identifies how frequently the relationship appears in the database. Support of X and Y. That means support that X is bought, Y is also bought, will be transaction containing both X and Y divided by total number of transactions. This is one thing you need to understand in this support levels. Once you have the idea of support, the second keyword you need to understand is confidence. Confidence. Number of number of items, these relationship, number of items where relationship found to be true. Found to be true. In how many instances the above relationship is found to be true. What I mean to say is, how many times X, Y is bought along with X? How many times Y is bought along with X? That is the understanding of confidence. Now, the formula of confidence is transactions containing both X and Y divided by transactions containing X. So, confidence, out of the number of X transactions, how many transactions were both X and Y? So, that is what confidence will tell us. So, confidence is where, how many times X and Y are bought together in total X transactions. That is, we call it as confidence. The third thing you need to understand is lift. The lift of the rule X to Y is the confidence of the rule divided by the expected confidence. Expected confidence. Assuming X and Y are independent items. Okay, so the lift formula is this. Lift of X, Y is equal to transactions contain both X and Y multiplied by transactions containing X, or sorry, divided by transactions containing X. And this is divided by fraction of transaction containing Y. So this is the formula for lift. Okay, all of you got this? All of you understood the three concepts: support, confidence, and lift, the three important parameters in market basket analysis?
Yes, sir.
Now, let us understand lift further. Lift greater than 1. Lift greater than 1 indicates presence of product A has increased the probability that product B will occur in transaction. So lift greater than 1 indicates if product A is present in the transaction, the probability that product B will occur also increase. Opposite of the same is less than 1. Suppose I'll copy the whole thing, Control C, Control V. Smaller than 1 indicates the presence of product has decreased the probability that product B will occur in transaction along with product A. So greater than 1, suppose you got lift of 1.25, it means there is a probability of 25% probability that product B will also be bought with product A. If the lift is, say, 1.25%, 25% chance is there that product A will be bought along with product B. So this is very important to understand the three concepts: support, confidence, and lift. Okay, I have already uploaded a data file called groceries in your classroom materials. Import that package called data called groceries. I have already uploaded a data called groceries. Data set is groceries.csv. Now we need to install packages. Install.packages a rules. First package we need to install is a rules. Install.packages a rules. Similarly, install.packages a rules viz. So groceries is equal to read.csv, file.choose, roll enter. All right, shall we proceed? Okay, A rules with V capital. A rules with V capital. I didn't, it asked me, so I forgot. A rules with V capital. So library A rules library A rules with so all of you have imported the groceries transaction data into R. Can you please confirm?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so these are the transaction data. Each row is equivalent to one transaction. Each row is one transaction. So we have to convert this into transactions. Okay, so because our data is in CSV file and it is giving you rows and columns like that, we don't need it like that. We need the data to be in transaction. Each row should be considered as transaction. Okay, so grocery is equal to read dot transactions. Okay. Give the name of the file groceries, comma. Format is equal to basket. Format is equal to basket. Comma separator is equal to comma, comma skip is equal to zero. So basically, generally skips the header. It thinks that the first row is header and it will skip it. We are saying not to skip it. Error in read lines file encoding, CON is not a connection. It says format is equal to basket. Let us say skip is equal to zero. We remove it. Thank you. I think we have to give the file format path, not the this way. One second. Properties, security, object name. Control C. Then where is the path here? Use the slashes. Comma. Format is equal to, let me put this thing in quotes. Format is equal to basket. Comma separator is equal to comma. So you have to give the complete file path. Read dot transactions, right click on the file, properties, security, you'll get the path and change the slashes. You have to change the slashes to opposite side. So right click, properties, security, and you will see the object name with file path and file name both. Select the complete thing, paste it here, and then change the slashes to opposite side and get the transactions. Then you add format is equal to basket, separator is equal to comma. What we got, summary, grocery. Yes. Yeah, transactions is item matrix in sparse format with 9,835 rows, elements or items or transactions and consistent columns and a density of 0.02. Most frequent items, whole milk, other vegetables, rolls, buns. You can get it. Elements, items divided by transaction, distribution, you'll get the data. So this is how you have to get the data into R. Give the path of the file, change the slashes, comma, and format is equal to basket, separator is equal to comma. Can you confirm once you have done with the importing, participants, please? All right, shall I continue?
Done, sir. You can continue.
Yeah. Now let us inspect. What are the first transactions? Inspect, open bracket, grocery, square bracket, 1:5. Let us see what are the first 5 transactions. I am saying the first 5 transactions. So the first 5 transactions include this. So first transaction is citrus food, margarine, ready soup, semi-finished bread. Second transaction include coffee, tropical food, yogurt. Third, only one product, whole milk. Fourth, cream cheese, meat spreads, pip fruit, yogurt. Fifth is condensed milk, long life bakery product, other vegetables, whole milk. So these are the transactions. See, it converted each row into a transaction. They were actually as rows in our data. Those rows have been converted into transaction. See? So each row will be one transaction within the curly braces. This is how it has to be. Transaction means all the products bought in one single bill or one single payment. Okay, so that is what we are seeing, the transactions. Okay, all of you got this? Now, let us see the frequent. What are the frequent items bought? This is called item frequency plot. It is called item frequency plot. Item frequency plot, grocery, comma, top N. Top N is equal to 15, comma, X lab is equal to item. So you get the top 15 products bought. So 25% of the product is whole milk. Around 20% is other vegetables, then rolls and buns, and then you have around 10 to 5%. These are the things. So you can see here the item frequency plot of top 15 products. If you want to see top 20 products, you can see the top 20 products. Okay, all of you got the graph, item frequency plot.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, we will run the a priori algorithm. We will run the a priori algorithm. So, a priori algorithm will generate association rules. Now, we have already done the frequency analysis. Now, we are going to do the what you call the rule analysis, rule-based analysis. Okay, initially we have done the frequency analysis. We have plotted the item frequencies. Okay, and now we can also create rules. Okay, now we can create rules for our transactions. rules is equal to a priori grocery comma parameter is equal to list of support is equal to 0.10 comma confidence is equal to 0.80. okay, so we are trying to create rules with support of 0.10 and confidence of 0.80. So a priori parameter 0. min val, max, false, false, algorithm control, true, minimum support 983, see transactions, sorting and recording items, item. Oh, it generated zero rules. Let us reduce the support. 0.005. Make it 0.001. Support is equal to 0.001. Confidence is equal to 0.8. Yeah. See, it has written 410 rules. So we have to reduce the support to 0.01. We got 410 rules. So let us see what are those rules. Options digits is equal to 2. Inspect rules square bracket 1:5. We are looking at the first 5 rules. So first 5 rules is liquor, red blush wine to bottled beer, support is 0.0019 and confidence is 0.90, coverage is 0.002, lift is 11.2, very high, count is 19 transactions are there. Cereals curd to whole milk, cereals yogurt to whole milk, butter jam to whole milk, bottled beer soups to whole milk. So these are the first 5 rules with support and confidence levels. So most rules are almost 3 items are the most rules have 3 items. So most of the rules are four product rules. We have five product rules and also we have six product rules, but most of them are four product rules. You can see here. Once you say summary rules, you can see here 229 rules are for four products. All of you got this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we will sort most likely rules. Most likely means or most frequent rules based on confidence. On confidence, we will sort the most likely or most frequent rules based on confidence. Or let us say sort most frequent rules based on confidence. Quick rules is equal to sort rules, comma, by is equal to confidence, comma, decreasing is equal to true. And what are the frequent rules? We can see here. We will not name it, actually it is not taking the thing, we will just use this one. Rules by confidence. Why are you not getting the output? One second. We have to use inspect. Weak rules is equal to sort rules by decreasing. Inspect weak rules square bracket 1:10. So these are the top rules based on confidence. So rice sugar to whole milk, confidence is 3.9. Canned fish, again 3.9. So you have rules in terms of, yes, you can inspect the rules based on frequencies. So all of you got the rules by confidence?
Yes, sir, yes, we got that.
Similarly, create rules by support. So freak rules 2 is equal to sort rules, comma, by is equal to support, comma, decreasing is equal to true. Inspect freak rules 2 square bracket 1:10. You can see the rules by support. Yes, Satish. Yeah. Scholar.google.com. No. In suppose situations, click on my profile and then give your Gmail ID and password or whatever ID password. And in that only there is something called on top, your profile or something, sign in will be there. Do it. Or type in Google Scholar, you'll get the link. Yeah. Come down once, I'll tell you. We have to do by lift also, right? Forgot it. Freak rules 3 is equal to sort rules, comma, by is equal to lift, comma, decreasing is equal to true. Inspect. Here.
It's coming, it is coming, it's not coming.
Then click on my profile.
Where is my profile?
Okay. Now you'll get a citation. See, this directly goes here.
You put what in search?
Google Scholar, yeah. Okay. So, freak rules 3, square bracket 1:5, by lift. What are the products by lift? You can find the products by confidence, by support, and by lift. Okay, all of you got the rules? How to select the rules?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now sometimes you need to do product wise rules. You have to create product wise rules. Okay, now one of the most frequent is whole milk. We have something called whole milk. Okay, so let us see what are the rules for whole milk. Whole milk rules is equal to a priori grocery, the data name is grocery, comma, parameter is equal to list of support is equal to 0.001, comma, confidence is equal to 0.80. So support and confidence we given, comma. Okay, support, same support and same lift I am giving. Then we'll add something called appearance is equal to list, open bracket, default is equal to left hand side LHS, default is equal to LHS, comma, RHS is equal to whole milk, comma, control is equal to list verbose is equal to true. So basically what we are trying to do is we are trying to find the rules for whole milk. Whole milk rules is okay, so whole milk rules is equal to a priori grocery, comma, parameter is equal to list, open bracket, support is equal to 0.001, comma, confidence is equal to 0.80, comma, appearance is equal to list, default is equal to LHS, RHS is whole milk, comma, control is equal to list, verbose true. So we got 252 rules. We got 252 rules where whole milk is on the right hand side or whole milk is bought along with the other products. Okay, now we will sort it. Whole milk rules is equal to sort whole milk rules, comma, by is equal to confidence, comma, decreasing is equal to true. Decreasing is equal to true. So we will create a list of rules based on confidence. Now we will inspect. Inspect whole milk rules, square bracket, 1:5. See, these are the top 5 rules that are coming with whole milk. You see, right hand side is all whole milk. So the first rule is rice, sugar, and whole milk, canned fish, hygiene articles and whole milk, butter, rice and root vegetables and whole milk, flour, root vegetables, whipped sour cream, whole milk, butter, domestic eggs, soft cheese, whole milk. So these are the top rules by confidence. So this is how we generate product-wise rules. All right. All of you got this? Let's just me zoom my plot. We can also plot it. Plot whole milk rules, comma, method is equal to graph. So these are the various products brought with whole milks. See, whole milk, what all about specialty cheese, like that we can do. Or we can simply say, we can plot the first 7 rules. 1:10. To see the graph properly. So this is the graph of the 10 rules. See here. So you can see the a priori graph. All right, all of you got this? Now, product wise rules for butter. Find out what are the product wise rules for butter. Thank you. Zero bills, okay. Okay, anybody got the rules for butter? So butter, you can copy the same thing from above. Butter rules is equal to a priori and copying everything from down. Here you have to, RHS has to be butter. Only thing is that. And run. Oh, we got zero rules, huh? For butter, we got zero rules. So what we can do is we look for another product. What are the second most product? Soda. Not butter rules, soda rules. Rules for soda. Butter is not that frequent, so you're not getting it. Oh, soda also we got very less rules. Let me reduce the confidence to 0.50. We got 43 rules. If you reduce the confidence to 0.50. If you raise it to 0.70, three rules. So inspect soda rules. Only three rules are there. If you take confidence of 0.70, plot soda rules, comma, method is equal to graph. We had a graph for three rules. Soda, miscellaneous beverages and coffee, soda, sausage, bottle beer and bottle water, soda, yogurt, roll buns and newspapers. Okay, so it is already 10:45. Shall we break for 15 minutes and come back at 11 o'clock? Participants, yes, can you confirm?
Okay, sir.